Okay, sorry this took so long. I had 2 hours of footage to go through and a lot of learning went into this project. So take a screenshot of all these materials that you will need. So I started off with clay onto the styrofoam base and I just mold it to how I want it to look. And when clay dries, it shrinks, so it's going to have these cracks in it. And I just super glued down any pieces that were falling off. And then I filled any holes with stucco. And after that, let it dry and I sand it so it's perfectly smooth. And next step is very important. I polyurethane it so it seals it all in. And then I put on gray paint so that when there's any gaps in the mirrors, it's not glaringly obvious. Then I take these mirror sheets, slice them into lines, peel off the backing because it comes with self-adhesive on the back, but I found that doesn't stick well enough, so I doubled up and I used E6000 or super glue in some places. And you're gonna need this tile cutter to actually cut the mirrors into even smaller pieces because along the edges and the curves, you're gonna need them to be half size, I found. So I just place these and fill any gaps. And the last step is I used a hot glue gun to just make some little padding feet so that it doesn't destroy any furniture that it sits on. I guess you can follow me for more DIYs because I just wasn't sure if anyone would be interested, but I found a better way to actually make the piece way more sturdy using a silicone mold and a two-part chemical process to be a singular sturdy piece that won't break off at all and is weight balanced. So not all the weight is on the tip and it won't have any issue of tipping over possibly on a shelf. It was really fun to do. I kind of did it because I was just interested in learning this new technique. But yeah, I guess if you want to learn more about that aspect, let me know.
If you're looking for ways to recycle, recycle with glassware from Goodwill or ones from your home and use them as decorative pieces with dried flowers. I've been trying a variety of different flowers, and this is a great way to preserve flowers if you have any for special occasions, whether it was weddings, a party, or just some that have a sentiment to you. So you definitely want to start first with the shortest stem and then the longest and fill with a variety. You can either leave as is, if it had a cap, you can put it back on, or you can add a candlestick for that extra flare. Here's how it turned out. I used them as decorative pieces to my fireplace mantle.
Okay, well now I have to have one above my bed. So I ordered some of these hedges. They are quite expensive, so I only got one box, which comes with 4 sheets of them. So hopefully that'll be enough. We'll make it work. And then I went to Joann's and picked out some flowers and started kind of cutting them into pieces so that I could stick them into the hedges. And I just kind of wanted to put them up and see like how much coverage I was going to get from the 4 hedges I ordered, and it wasn't really that much, so it wasn't going to be nearly as big as hers, but I figured I could still make it work. On the back, the material has these spots for nails, so you can really easily nail it to the wall. You could also use tacks or command strips too if you're renting and can't put holes in your walls. So then I just put the flowers and the vines straight into the hedges. Because of that material on the back, it makes it really easy to do this. And here was the before, and here is the after. I love how this turned out. It reminds me of something out of a fairy tale. Be sure to tag the original creator. Make sure you check out her content and give her a follow.
Thank you. If I lose you,
how to make these super fun women figures vases, so perfect for a ladies' night. So all you're gonna need is some air dry clay and some thrifted glassware. Now, air dry clay works without the glassware, but I wanted to put water in it afterwards, so I highly recommend. So you're gonna cover the glass in the air dry clay, and anything you wanna add, you're gonna add a scoring technique in order to make sure it has a nice firm hold. And then in order to get that smooth pottery feel, run under some water, get out the imperfection, and let dry for about a day and a half, and here you have it, beautiful vases.
You can do so much with tile samples. Here's an idea. Divide a subway tile into three parts. Give it a little border, then use a stencil to write something cute, or you can write something demanding and forceful like I did.
I've been wanting to bring this idea to life for a while. I got these vases in bowl at the thrift store. This one had super cute hearts on it. I cleaned them up really, really well. Scrub it up, dip, 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 dip. Let them dry, then I mix some Mod Podge with food coloring. I used red and a couple drops of blue. Swirl that shit around. This part was so satisfying. Right on the edge of glory. Then I let it dry overnight. Actually, this is what it looked like right after. I put it in the oven at 250 for about an hour. Oh my gosh, this is what it looks like right after. Now I just need twinkly light.
Nobody's gonna know. Nobody's gonna know.
They're gonna know. How would they know?
I found out yesterday that our house is going to be featured in apartment therapy, and they're sending a photographer. So last night I did this frantic last minute DIY project. We had three of these broken, old, ugly, patterned planter pots, and I asked Andrew to just paint whatever he wanted on it, and he made these beautiful gradients, and I'm so happy with the outcome. It's so much better, and it was so fast and easy.
So I fell in love with this mirror on Urban Outfitters, but what I didn't fall in love with was the price, and I realized that this would just be so easy to make on my own, so that's what I did. I ordered a mirror off of Amazon. This one is similar to the one that I actually got.
When it came, it was actually a lot bigger than I initially expected, which I loved, and I just got these normal LED strip lights. I used Gorilla Glue and I glued the power box to the back so that was hidden, and then I went around the perimeter with the self-adhesive strip lights. It was so easy, and I just went around twice with the lights so that it would come out and be really vibrant from the back. Plug it in, make sure that it works. Yay. All that was left to do was mount it, and this is how it turned out. I'm seriously so in love with it. The best part is you can use any mirror that you want, and you can change the colors based off of the LED lights that you get, so I definitely recommend.
Feel it burn. Rock me in your arms. I can't feel it burn.